before. A pivot is actually going to help you identify what you're making. So how much you're making. Look at a pip as a footstep, right? A footstep that you're doing. So you're going, you're walking down a block and you take a step. That's your pip. So to get to block B, you have to take 10 steps. That's 10 pips, right? You have to take 10 pips. Now, if you want to get to the next block and that's another 10 steps, that's 20 total, right? So you have to take 20 pips. 20 pips is, think about it as steps. That's pretty much when price is actually moving up or down each step. So if price is going up, it's moving up a step at a time. Each pip is a step. It's moving down, it's taking a step at a time. Each pip is going down a pip, right? Taking a step down every time, right? So that's what a pip actually is. Now we're gonna go into your next question. What does lot size? This is your next question, right? Your next question is, what does lot size mean? So what is a lot size? What does lot size mean? How do you want to phrase it, right? Your lot size is actually you're determining how much money you're willing to put inside of the actual market. So I'm going to show you an actual cheat sheet for you to write down that's going to benefit you to understand what actual lot size is, right? So a lot size is this. I have a question. What's up? So your lot size is actually, you have everything on the left is your lot size. A 0.01 is considered 10 cents within the market, right? 10 cents per pip. So 10 cents per step that you take, 10 steps. Per the market is moving. So you have 10 cents per pip. So if you wanted 20 pips, remember that 20 mile block, right? That you wanted to walk to, you put 10 cents, is a 0.1, a 0.01 in the market, you will make $2 inside of the market at that point in time, right? So you're actually making $2 out of 10 cents, right? So I'm gonna repeat that again. You put in 10 cents, you have a pip, the market moved 20 pips, 20 steps of you walking that block, you have made $2, right? So now you say, okay, the market has moved 40 pips, but I wanted to put in 20 cents. Now you have the equivalent of $8 that you just made, 20 cents turned into eight, right? 20 cents just turned into $8 by the price of the currency that you're trading moved only 40 pips, which is 40 steps, right? So now if you say, okay, I understand that. How is there any way I can make a dollar turn into X amount, right? That's when you put your point one zero in, right? Your 0.10 equals a dollar, right? Your 0.10 equals a dollar. Now, if the price of the currency that you're trading has moved 20 pips, that dollar you would have made $20. Because you only put a dollar inside of the market. So from that dollar, you have made $20 because price took 20 steps, 20 pips, whether you were buying or whether you were selling, right? So as you get from there, then you can also do a standard. Your standard lot size will be $10 or more. That $10, you can actually turn that $10 into $200. The price took 20 steps, 20 pips, up or down, whichever one you decided to do, buy or sell, you made that $10 turn into $200. And now that can vary between time. What do I mean when I say that? That $10 could go to $200 within a couple minutes, an hour, days, weeks, whatever the case may be that you're actually trading. It's all up to you and the market, whatever the market's going to do. You will understand that as more time goes on. This is the basics of the basics that of trading. You know, we're not going to go all in detail. This is the very basis of it, right? So now that you have that lot size, right, you understand that. So far, is everybody on board with what I'm talking about? If you understand, you know, drop a one in the chat if you understand what I'm talking about or anything that case may be. Let's see. Make sure you guys are on track. Cool, cool, cool. You guys understand where I'm at, where I'm going at. Cool. Now, this next one, I want you guys to actually write down what is a stop loss What is a stop loss and take profit? Right? What is a stop loss and take profit? Write that question down. Now, a stop loss. A stop loss is your safety net. What do you mean by safety net, Vic? Like, I don't understand. What's the safety net? Actually, now think about it. Your safety net is, now, you know how I said you wanted to walk 20 blocks, right? So as you were moving 20 blocks, but then you got a call from your friend telling you, yo, turn around. I need you to come back. And you left your wallet. So you had to go turn around, go back the other direction. So now you're not making progress into where you were going, to point B. You have to turn around, make steps backwards, go back to point A. Right? You're going back to where you started. That's your stop loss. So now that means if you bought a currency at whatever price 1, 2, 3, and price decided to take 20 pips downward, right? Because you're selling that currency and price started to go down 20 pips. But remember that phone call happened, so it went back the other way to where you started from and hit your stop loss, hit your entry, or hit a little bit past your entry. That stop loss, that safety net is there to help you not lose any more money than you're willing to lose. So what do I mean by that? Okay, boom. You wanted to sell a currency pair, right? You sold it down so much. So I'll actually show you on the chart, right? We're going to look at it like this. You wanted to sell a currency pair, right? You're selling from up here in this area. You're going down, right? And price decided to go right back up. It did in here, but price decided to go back up past to where you started. Your stop loss will actually help you. So if you said, I want to sell this currency down and make $40 from it, right? But price said, no, I'm not doing that today. I'm actually going to go the opposite way. It went the opposite way. Now you said that $20 you were trying to make, you could have had your stop loss set for you would only lose $5, $10, you know, or break even at 20. So you would have the option to place on whether you want your stop loss, say, you know, go way too, you know, stop, how much you're willing to risk, your risk to reward, long story short, right? Now your take profit, that's pretty simple. Like I just said, if you wanted to sell price from up here and you wanted to take your profit down here, so meaning you wanted to put 10 cents in the market, price would have moved 20 pips. That's what, $2 back to the lot size, what we were talking about. So if you put in a dollar and price moved 20 pips, what is that? You would have made $20, right? So that's how you would look at it from your stop loss and your take profit, right? The very basics of what it actually is, right? So those are big things that you really need to understand. We're going to go over another one. What is a trend line, right? I'm not going to type these questions out because these I'm actually going to actually show you visually on the chart so you guys can actually see and understand exactly what I'm talking about. What is a trend line? Remember that, install this in your head. What is a trend line, right? A trend line is actually showing you where price is moving, showing you the trend is your friend, right? Price is actually going to go with you. So you see something like this. Let's go from here, right? You see anything like this, this is called your trend line, right? Your trend line is coming all the way, however you want to look at it. Your trend line is coming downward. Something that is going down, that another word for a downward trend is called a bearish trend. Bearish trend, that is your bearish trend. It is a downward trend, right? So now another way that you can have a trend line is this. You see price going up. What is that considered? You can consider that your quick bullish trend, right? Simple. Bullish, buy, bearish, sell. Uptrend, downtrend. Whatever is simple for you to understand, right? That is exactly what that is, right? So now, looking at this chart, we do have these things. People are saying, what are these green and white things standing here, right? I'm going to tell you now, these are called candlesticks, right? Your candlesticks will help you and tell you exactly what's going to happen within the market, right? Your candlesticks will help you and tell you exactly what's going to happen within the market. Right? There are many other ways you can go about it. This is your most simplest way and form that you can do this, all right? So now we have these green candlesticks. When price is going up, right? What does that mean? That indicates a bullish movement. You can change these candlesticks, whatever color you want. They'll be green and white, blue, red, yellow, whatever color you desire. It really doesn't matter. So green is your bullish candlesticks. Can somebody in the chat tell me, what did I just say? Green is your bullish candlesticks. What does that mean? What does the word bullish mean again? I ran through it recently. Can somebody tell me in the chat, what does the word bullish mean? You can type it in the chat as well. Yep, bullish is up, uptrend. Exactly. That's exactly what bullish actually means, right? So then that's what that indicates, price is going up. So you would want to buy on a bullish motion, right? Price is going up. Now, what is the green? What is the, I mean, the white candle? The white candle is what? Bearish, right? The white candle is actually going down, right? The white candle is actually going down, right? Yep, exactly. That is exactly what bearish means. Simple as that. Now, if people say, okay, now how do I really understand how can I make money within the market? How? Say, okay, I got the green, I got the greens and whites, I got the bearish and bullish, cool, I got the trend lines, I'm good to go. What's another way to make money in the market? Another way to make money in the market is actually, if you can tell me that you know how to read these two letters right here, I'm gonna write these two letters. Okay, I guess I got frozen for a split second. My bad, I am back. So we're gonna continue on what I was saying, right? So if you can read these two letters, is that where I left off? You guys were able to hear me when I said if you can read these two letters? I'm gonna go with that, yeah. All right, cool. So if you can read these two letters, right, to understand, like, you have your bearish, you have your bullish, you have your trend lines, your ups and downs, right? Now, if you can read an M and a W, that's exactly how you can trade. If you can read an M and a W, that's exactly how you can trade, right? Now, a lot of people are going to say, okay, cool, show me. What do you mean if I can read an M and a W? How does that distinguish if I know how to trade, right? Look at this. You have this red line that I just drew. That is an M, right? What does that indicate that look like? A sell. Price is going down, right? Down here. You can actually sell. Once you see an M created, you can actually sell, right? Now look. Draw this. What does that look like? A W. It ain't no fancy W that you see like in a notebook or a textbook or something, but you do have a W here that indicates what? Buy, right? Boom. Trading is literally that easy. Like I said, it's not something that you can jump in the market and be like, yo, I'm a six-figure trader. I just started trading a week ago. Now I'm lit. I'm singing Bobby Shmurda and I got the shmoney dance going on. No, that's not going to happen. If anything, you'll probably just be sad because that's not going to happen because it's not happening overnight. So like I'm saying, this is something that takes time. I like to imagine it like lacrosse. It's easy to learn, but it's hard to get good at, right? That's exactly how trading is. It's literally that simple when it comes down to trading, right? So as of right now, does anybody have any questions whatsoever? If you have a question, write it down in the chat. Let me know. We got a question. Somebody's about to say something. Or they were just plugging in. Let's see. No question. All right, cool. So we do not have a question right now. Yeah. Yo, you got a question? Nope, I don't think so. There it is. Let's see. Anybody? Nope. All right, keep hearing a voice, but nobody's speaking.
Bro, show my team how to change the colors on Telegram on TradingView of their candlesticks. We got a couple new students on here.
All right, cool. Yeah, definitely. So everybody goes. So you will go to your settings. I don't know what kind of computer you have. You right click, double. If you have a Mac, two finger click. Go to your settings. Candles is right here. You can change from everything that you want on your candles, however you want to do it. It's under symbols. Candles, you got your greens. I have my greens for my bullish. And my whites, my bearish, which these would be it right here, right? That's how you would do trading view on your candles, right? Oh, and the best thing about this too, I love about trading for those who are just now learning how to trade. Definitely, you're not even, you're thinking about trading still, you know, you have questions and all that. You pretty much want to say, oh, hold on, I have a question right now. I'm looking for it. I had a difficulty. Can you show the average of correctly placing trade, or do you have a video? Okay, we're going to go over how to actually place a trade in a few. So we're going to actually do this. So look, when you guys are trading and you do jump inside of a trade, since you have total control of your money, you set an alert. How do you set an alert? So say if you wanted to sell here and you was like, I'm going to show you a quick example, right? You wanted to sell here, right? You wanted to sell right here and you was like, all right, I got to go to work. I got to go to the gym or whatever the case may be. You set an alert until price, like for where your TP will hit and where your stop loss will hit. How do you set an alert, Vic? I'm going to show you how to set it, right? You see this little clock at the top? All you would have to do is click on it. Once you click on it, type in price where you would want to get notified to your phone where price is at. So if you have a TP down here, I'll show you a quick example. If you had a TP, a take profit, right? Down here, right? At 11603, you would put in, you would hit alert, then you would type that in for you. You would go type 11603. Boom. Your alert is now there. You won't have to worry about it. It's there now. Give me a second. We have another question. Boom, right? So now that is your alert. Your alert will now, you would now get a notification sent to your phone. So what I like to do, I like to put an alert towards my stop loss area. So I got a 20 pip stop loss, which goes back. The price moved 20 pips. What is 20? What is a pip? A step, right? Price went backwards the other way. Now I'm notified at least 10 pips or like 5 pips before we hit 20, that price is about to hit stop loss. And the reason I like to do it with stop loss is because if my phone's not ringing, I'm good. I'm good. I don't care what I'm in or anything like that. I'm clear. I'm good to go, right? That's why I personally like using the alert towards my stop loss. Now, if you say, I don't care, I don't want to put it next to my stop loss, I only want to know when my trade hits take profit, TP, I'm going to put a stop alert in at my TP, by all means, go for it. I'm not in charge of you. You know, nobody's in charge of you. You're in charge of yourself. You do what you got to do, right? Do we have somebody drawing on here? All right, cool. So you're in charge of yourself. That is the difference between that. We have somebody that's trying to get on from Instagram. What up, guys? We have somebody else trying to get on. Let me just write this password down. We have somebody. So sorry, does anybody else have any questions about anything? Especially for the newer people? Anybody that's been trading for a while has any questions whatsoever? Because if not, I'm not going to be the one to go back and go in it. So speak now, forever hold your peace. Close mouths, don't get fed, right? All right, cool. We have no questions on that. So boom. So now that being said, that is the most basic, simplest thing when it comes down to trading. I'm going to break down. I'm not trying to go in too much detail for you guys, so you guys won't be lost in the sauce. So you guys won't be like, yo, what's going on? I don't get it, right? Cool. We're actually going to go over your orders. You can actually set orders within this market, right? So this is for the people that's like, I don't have time in the day. Like, I can't be sitting here watching the charts 24/7 every day of the week. You know, I can't do that. I don't got time for that. Whatever the case may be. The thing you can do is actually set an order. Right? Where we at? So another thing you can do is called setting an order. What is an order? You have, you can set like, I'm gonna just give you one example, a sell limit, right? A sell limit would be that, say if you learned how to read this and you knew price was gonna come up and sell, right? Like you had no doubt about it, you knew price was coming up to sell once price hit a certain point, right? So say if you took a sell limit right up here, right? This black line, I don't know if some of you can see that. I'm going to make it a little bit brighter. Yellow. This yellow line, that's my sell order. I'm going to sell. I want, when price gets up here, I have no doubt about it. I know price is selling. I know it's going down. It's going down all the way to the ground, right? Down, down, baby, right? Like the song. So what are you going to do? You set your sell limit to price of 11843, right? That's exactly how you do it. 11843 on your MetaTrader 4. So you go to your MetaTrader 4. So if you're not using your phone, you can just take your phone out and go to your MetaTrader 4. And if not, I'll just show you mine, actually. What pair are we on? EU. You're on EU right now. So you would go to your MetaTrader 4, right? You would click on that. Some phones are different, but you would click on market execution, right? Obviously, the market is closed right now, so it's not going to work. But you would go to sell limit, right? Once you go to sell limit, you place your lot size on your phone. This is all from your phone. You can use your computer as well, but you place your lot size, right? Once you place your lot size, then you would go type in price. So my sell limit is at 11843. So price, I will go to 11843. Then I will go to stop loss, right? So say you're just gonna pick a random number, right? Say if you said my stop loss was here, right? We'll do, what color should we do? Let's go red. Red is my stop loss. 11915. I will go to stop loss. Type in that price. 11915, right? Now say okay, when this when EU sells, that joint gonna drop. It's gonna drop, right? And you wanna put your TP down here, right? We'll go green. Now you type in on your take profit, right? The green. So if you have an Android, is this gonna show up red on the left, a red line on the left, and a green line on the right? This is gonna show up like that. I have an iPhone. So you would type in 11448. And then once you do that, since the market is closed, it won't work. Now your sell limit is in play. All you would have to do is hit place. It's not going to work, right? Market doesn't work because the market is closed. But market's open, you would hit place. Once you hit place, you close your phone and go enjoy the rest of your day. Don't have to worry about nothing else. Your phone is closed. This is when your alerts could kick in. I'm like, okay, cool. I want to send an alert right before price hits. So you want to set an alert like right up here, right? You want to set an alert like, oh, my entry is 11843. I want to set an alert right before it. So what you would do, go to the clock up top, go to the clock, type something in that makes it go right before it. And then your alert would be set. So when price actually gets back to that level, all you would have to do, your phone, computer, tablet, watch, whatever you have, will ring and say, yo, hello, like, yo, price is at that area you were just talking about. And then you already know, oh, I got my pending order set. My sell limit is set. It's going to sell. I'm good to go. Now you can check it, which I advise you to check. But if you're very confident, you don't have to check it. Totally up to you. Like I said, I'm not your boss. Definitely you do as you please. You do what you want, right? So let's see. We have any. So far, everybody's good, I'm assuming. We don't have any more questions. I know. Who was it that said they had the question? Hey, Kim, did I answer your question on how to place your orders? You got to mute yourself too if you want. I'm not sure if you can. Okay, yes, I was able to follow. Okay, cool, great. Happy that helped you. So far, that's pretty much the basics of how to trade in the foreign exchange market, right? That's the very most basic way to think about this. So I'm going to ask you guys questions. So I'm going to expect, you know, some interactions with you guys. Put my candles back to light. Some interactions from some of you guys just to go over the little basics to see if you guys can. Feel free to unmute yourself to speak when the question is asked, or type your answer in the question. I will sit and I'll play some music while y'all thinking about your answer. Y'all get, it's gonna be like musical chairs. Y'all get a couple seconds, think about your answer, and keep it rolling from there. All right. So, can somebody tell me, real basic, right here, what kind of candle is this? Type in the chat and tell me what kind of candle is that. Hold on, I got a question too. Okay, cool. Bullish. Oh, okay, cool. I was about to say, I don't know what the rest of the letters meant. But yeah, bullish. All right, cool. All right, now we're going to go. Let's get another question. Let's see. What is this white candle? What is this white candle considered on my chart? Bearish. All right. Yep. Now we're gonna add a little bit more into this. Can somebody tell me? Oh, got a question. Can somebody tell me what kind of trend is this right here? Like, say if I went from here, what kind of trend are we looking at? If we were coming up here, this black line.
That's an upward trend, isn't it?
Yeah. Was that Rondella?
Oh, shit.
All right, cool. Yeah, you was right. I don't think you meant to unmute yourself, but yeah, you were right. That is an uptrend, right? Another word for that is what? What's another word for an uptrend? Bullish. Cool beans. All right, now we're going to go very simple. What kind of trend, what would a black line like this look like? So what would that look like to you? What kind of trend would that be to you? Like just looking at it really quick, very simple. There, downtrend, bearish trend, down, yep, exactly. Cool. So all right, let me ask you guys a question. How many of you that's on this call right now has actually been trading for less than 30 days? Drop a one in the chat if you've been trading less than 30 days. Okay, cool. On demo only. Okay, that's cool. There's nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. All right, now, drop a two in the chat if you've been trading 60 days or less. 2 months or less, if you couldn't do the math right. But yeah, about that. If you've been trading for at least 2 months, drop a two. Okay, so now, from looking at this, we got a lot of ones in the chat, a few twos. So I definitely know we have a lot more people trading at least 3 months or more, right? So that makes sense. Cool. So since we do have a lot more people that are that has been trading a little bit longer, this might be, like I said, this might be very simple to you guys, but I will go over a little bit more basic, a little bit more things, somewhat of advance. I'm gonna give you guys like a quick tip on. It will come in handy too for our new people. So we have this thing called head and shoulders, right? Very simple. This looks just like this, right? A head and shoulders. We got a shoulder here. The head's the long one and the shoulder here, right? That's what you consider a head and shoulders, right? This is for people that are very new and obviously people that's been in trading longer than 3 months. You clearly know already, right? So what is that, right? Head and shoulders. How can you find a head and shoulders anywhere else, right? I'm going to show you. Look at this, right? So let's go backtrack a little bit. Right? So what do you have here, right? You have a shoulder, a head, and you have a slight small shoulder, right? Head and shoulder. Like I said, we're not going to go in detail too much, but we're going over simple things, right? Price hit, price sold, right? Might have not been for a lot, but price still sold, right? Head and shoulders is going to be a big factor to you. Look, start training your eyes how to read a head and shoulder pattern. If you don't know how to read a head and shoulders pattern, I recommend drawing it up multiple times. Drawing it up multiple times and seeing how to actually draw a head and shoulders pattern. So, like, literally draw it up every time you can. So what I would say is it'll look just like this. So it looks more clean to you, for you guys. You have a head and shoulders, right? This one will indicate a buy. So besides your M&Ws, you'll see this. A buy, head and shoulders. Your left shoulder, right shoulder. I know some people gotta visually see, like, left shoulder. Right shoulder. Right. So we have left shoulder, right shoulder, head. That will indicate what? You're by. Then we're gonna go into right. This is gonna indicate if this one over here indicated a buy, what do you guys think this one over here indicates?
Yeah.
Exactly. Sell, right? So definitely draw those two out nonstop. Like, if you could draw those out every single day, by all means, go ahead. If you don't want to, also, by all means, don't. But just remember, your effort will determine your progress, right? Like I said, don't make this too difficult. Don't make this crazy, guys. Like, you guys will... You will understand this sooner or later. Because I tell you what, when I first started, I didn't know any of this from a nail off the wall. It took me time after time after time to actually understand what is going on within this market, right? Like I said, there's way more things you can do, but this is the most simplest way you can actually look at the market. Look for your W's, look for your M's, look for your head and shoulders. And then you let the rest of it play its course. You know, you got your candles, your bullish, your bearish. There's way more. So it's like that. That's pretty much it on that half of it. Anyone else has any questions about anything? Let's see. Appreciate it, Sebash. Yo, but nah, for real, like, I really didn't know any of this when I first started doing this at all. It took me time after time to learn all of this and just pretty much asking everybody and their grandmas, moms, uncles, and grandpas on how to actually trade. Sebash, he's in the chat as well. He was actually the first person to teach me actually like 101 on how to actually trade in this, right? So nobody has any questions whatsoever. For the people that all dropped ones, you guys understand this to 100. What time frames do you recommend to search for the trend? Okay, that's a good question. I'm going to tell you now. Everyone's going to be a little bit different. My method of trading might be a little bit different between, you know, whoever's mentoring you on trading, right? Or somebody else you're watching. But I would recommend, like, the basics, whatever you hear in most videos, top down. You can start from your daily, 4 hour, 2 hour, 1 hour, and go down. Your weekly, daily, 4 hour, 1 hour. And then you can start messing around with your 15 for entries and whatnot. But like I said, everyone is going to be different. Once you, like, you can follow the basic steps from everybody that you're learning from. And then eventually you'll start to see what works for you and what doesn't work for you. Does that make any sense? If that makes sense, just let me know. If it doesn't, I'll try to rephrase what I just said. I guess that makes sense. All right, cool. Anybody else that typed a one in the chat? Do you have any questions at all? Whatsoever, any questions? You have no questions. That means I can call anybody that dropped a one in the chat right now and question them on whatever we just went over. That's very simple. If there's no question from anybody that typed that, less than 30 days.
I have a question.
Yeah, what's up?
Can you explain like when you're like in profit and then when you're not again? Like when to buy and then when to sell?
So like when you're selling, let's go up here. So if you're selling and then price decides, so if say if you entered, here, right? So, mm-hmm. you're saying, so like what happens, say if you entered here and price decided to go down but come all the way back up?
Yeah. So what? I guess like,
like what does it mean?
Yeah, like would you sell at that point or would you buy at that point?
Oh no, if you're selling, just stick to yourself. I wouldn't jump around and trying to, like, you're selling here, you had all confirmation that you should sell and price is going down and you're selling and price decides to go back up. Don't be like, oh, let me go buy it, because all the market is doing is fluctuating. So imagine if you sold here and you see price going back up and you're kind of, if you were in $20 in profit, right?
Mm-hmm.
Price is going back up and then now you were like, oh man, I'm only in like a dollar in profit now. Like, oh, that means it's going up for a buy. And you closed it, went to buy it. Look what happened. Where did price go? Back down, right?
Down. Okay.
You would have been a sad cookie over there. You know? So just
yeah. Let, okay.
Once you get your confirmation, your bias, stick and run with it, and that's the best thing I can tell you. Because if not, I'm going to let you know now, that's going to be like, you're just going to have a headache every day. Because you're like, oh, I just closed out and now the market went the right way I was going, you know?
Mm-hmm.
If you have good risk to reward, you shouldn't have to worry about it. So like, if you're like, oh, I'm only going to lose $5. Like, yeah, you lose $5, but it's like, you're willing to lose that, you know?
All right. Thank you.
No problem. We got a question in the chat. Let's see what this question is. Why doesn't the chat never show up? If it is a buy head and shoulder pattern, do you buy after that pattern shows or you assume the pattern will show and buy in the middle? Good question. Cool. So if you have a head and shoulder, so let's go here. This is all going just going off the 1 hour really quick, right? So if you have a head and shoulders, the easiest way to show you is actually drawing. So your head and shoulders would happen. You see this happening, right? Looking at the market, never look at the market going to enter a trade. Don't be like, I'm going to look at the market and be like, I have to trade as soon as I look at it. You do that, I promise you, most of the time, you're going to lose money. Unless you're going into like maybe scalp or something. I have no idea about scalping. I know everybody that does it. They can say, yo, I'm going to go make a couple trips real quick. They can do that, not me. So check this out. If you're going to actually go and trade, like you're going to look for setup. You're going to set something up, you know, before you actually enter the trade. That's kind of like you getting ready for a basketball game. What are you going to do? You're going to set yourself up, right, for greatness. You're going to go practice. You're going to go look for like, yo, all right, if this team runs a 3-2, what are we going to do to break it, right? So what do you do is you're looking at the market. The market's actually, so if you see something like this happen, right, you see a left shoulder created, right, market's going down, and you see that, you know, price is starting to go back up. When price goes back up, what can you do? You can, you know, you could, like I said, it's not going to be as pretty, but you can draw your line and be like, okay, I want to see when price gets here, right? Let me draw that out for you. When price gets when price goes up, right? And now you're like, all right, I'm going to wait until price comes back up. I'm not going to jump in because I'm not worried. I don't have to take every trade. I'm going to jump back in when price comes around here. I'm going to see how price reacts over here. That's when, once you get more into trading and you learn your candlesticks and about price action, that's for a whole nother webinar for people, you know, you get a little bit more, I wouldn't say advanced because I'm not an advanced trader. I just trade. But it's more for when you understand actually the words, right? When you actually understand a lot more of it. You would wait and see how price reacts off of this, right in this zone. And then you would buy. So who's that? Albert? Oh, long picture. Albert. I think that was Albert, right? If it was Albert, if that's your name, right? I gotta look at the chat again. Did that make any sense? Yeah, I get it. All right, cool. Yeah, so definitely don't rush to jump in any trade. If you rush to jump in a trade, the trade's gonna not care about your feelings. So you rush, the trade's gonna rush and take your money. So that's that on there. Anybody else has a question that typed in a one? I'm surprised there's not many questions for everybody that typed in a one. I know it was basic, but if you typed a one in, I feel like you should have a whole bunch of questions. Even if it didn't pertain to what I just showed you, because since this was so simple, you should have a question about anything when it comes down to trading, right? If not, hey, by all means, I guess you got it all good. Cool. All right, so that's pretty much it on the basics of trading with the banks. That's the 101. I will be hosting another webinar this weekend. It is the weekend now. Tomorrow. But tomorrow's webinar will be more in detail, more a little bit, like I said, quote unquote, if you want to call it advanced. About, so it's gonna be what we did, but kind of a step up a notch. So definitely, if I were you guys, I would advise you to really crack down in the books, study up. I know it is the weekend. You know, if you do go out, at least study before you go out, and then study when you get home if you can. You know, it's gonna be amazing. And for those of you that's on this call that's not partnered up with myself, feel free. Hit me up, send me a DM on Instagram, Facebook, or if you have me on Telegram and you're just not partnering up with us at all, definitely feel free. What time? The time will be let out tomorrow, well, later tonight. Yeah, later tonight. I'm looking around the same time frame, around that 7 o'clock as of tonight, 7 o'clock Eastern. So, yes, if you're not part of the trading platform with myself, definitely feel free to contact me. I know a lot of you, I see, you know, you guys are with it, within a platform. You are trading. What's my Instagram? My Instagram is actually, yeah, I'll type it for you guys. Oh, that's a trend line. My Instagram is at mr.vickterry. Pretty simple. This is my Instagram. So once again, if you guys are not within the platform, if you guys got this link from my Facebook, and you guys are brand new, don't know anything about what I'm talking about still, and you want more, feel free, follow me on Instagram. If you have me on Facebook only, Instagram only, my name is the same thing. Same, YouTube is a little bit different. YouTube is Tyree Fit. That's a little bit different. It will be changed within tonight. But definitely, once again, this is mainly for everybody that's brand new, that's already being mentored, and that's within the platform with us, within the organization. And for people that's, like I said, found me on social media and just wanted to learn a little bit about it. So once again, feel free, hit me up in my DMs on Facebook or Instagram. Other than that, thank you for participating within this webinar. Can't wait to see you guys for tomorrow's webinar. Like I said, tomorrow's going to be a lot more advanced. So I highly recommend you jump on this webinar tomorrow. Be ready to take even more notes than what you did today, because we're going to go pretty deep into everything that we just spoke about. And if you guys don't believe me, just, you're going to be in a rude awakening tomorrow, right? But other than that, once again, I go by the name of Mr. Vickterry. Thank you for joining this webinar, and I'm definitely going to see a lot of you guys tomorrow. Other than that, hope y'all have a nice weekend and enjoy yourself. All right? Catch y'all later.